Today is pi day, so let's look at how to compute pi, 3.14159 dot dot dot, with a spreadsheet. Here I'll be using LibreOffice, but you can use Excel or Google Docs or whatever, it does not matter. If you're any familiar with spreadsheets, you probably know about the pi function. But what other ways are there of getting the value of pi? Other than the pi function, there are also the inverse trigonometric functions for us to use. Here we have 4 times of arctangent 1, 2 times of arccosine 1, 6 times of arccosine half, 2 times of arccosine 0, and 3 times of arccosine half, all of them giving the value of pi. Here's a completely different approach. We start with a square of side length 2, and pick random points within it. The probability of a random point lying in the shaded circle is the ratio of the areas, which is pi for the circle over 4 for the square. By measuring the proportion of our random samples that lie within the circle, and then multiplying this value by 4, we get an approximation of pi. These are the coordinates of the random samples, and this tests whether the point chosen lies within the shaded circle. By counting the number of such samples and dividing by the total number and multiplying by 4, this is the approximation of pi we get. The approximation obtained in this manner typically isn't very good, and getting just 5 correct digits consistently will require billions of samples. Here's the fairly well-known Gregory Leibniz series, 1 over 1 minus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 5 minus 1 over 7 plus 1 over 9 and so on equals to arctangent of 1 equals to pi over 4. So we add all of these values up and multiply by 4 to get an approximation of pi. As with the Monte Carlo method, this converges very slowly, and to get 5 correct digits will require thousands of terms. There are many related formulae of this type that converge more quickly, such as this one. This column is obtained by dividing the values in column B by 2 to the power of 2k plus 1, which sums to arctangent of half. This column is obtained by multiplying the values in column B by, dividing the values in column B by 3 to the power of 2k plus 1, and this adds up to arctangent of 1/3. Adding up the values in these two columns gives pi over 4, so we can multiply that by 4 again and we will get an approximation of pi. This converges much faster than the earlier examples, giving about 1 correct digit with every 2 rows of terms. Until now, we've showcased a couple of formulae for calculating pi, as well as a few ways of getting the value of pi hard-coded in the spreadsheet software. However, you might have noticed that in every case, we had quite few digits shown. For example, we had 8 decimal places here. Can we get more? Of course, if we just widen the cell, we can get up to 14 decimal places. But can we have even more? If you have your pi digits memorized, you should know that after 979 comes 323, but the spreadsheet is telling us that there are zeros there instead. This is because the spreadsheet will only ever show up to 15 significant figures, which in this case means that everything after the 979 will be treated as zeros. Not just that, even if we somehow coaxed it into showing more digits, it only works with about 17 significant figures on the inside, so we will get at most 2 more or 3 more digits, and the rest will still be zeros. If you want to calculate, say, 100 digits of pi, we will have to write a program to compute that, and we can do that in a spreadsheet without resorting to any macros. This will be covered in the second part of the video.